Good morning. My name is Nienke van Schavenbeke, and I'm heading up the collections team at Europeana. Thank you very much for the kind invitation to speak here today at Toegangsgestalten. Today I will be sharing with you our experiences in connecting people with our shared digital cultural heritage. This year, Europeana celebrates its 10-year anniversary, and over the course of these past years, we've built up an incredible corpus of over 55 million digital objects from over 3,700 heritage institutions across Europe, accessible through the website and the API. This is our website. You can access it through europeana.eu. And we truly believe that access to a shared heritage, whether it's in music, books, films, art or social history, makes people's lives richer. And our collection aims to make this valuable content more accessible, more beneficial to more people through inspiring exhibitions, galleries, blogs, and our dedicated thematic collections on art, music, photography, First World War, fashion, sport, but also manuscripts. We are bringing together the cultural heritage organizations that have the great content with the people and the sectors that want to research, share, and create new things. So at Europeana, and our director Harry Verwaaien spoke about this yesterday already, we have three main strategic priorities: to make it easier for our cultural heritage institution to share their high quality content, to work with partners, for example, in research, education, and creative industries, to reach our target audiences, and to engage people on our website through participatory campaigns. So today I would like to focus on the last one, engaging people by placing digital cultural heritage where people are, whether this is through Wikipedia, Pinterest, other social media channels, but also in the streets, through collection days and transcribathons. So this year, it's the European Year of Cultural Heritage. We spoke about this also yesterday. And Europeana is the proud digital face of the year, and we're very excited to be running two major participatory campaigns this year: Europeana Migration and a centenary tour for Europeana 1914-1918, both allowing people to show how their past have shaped our present. Starting with Europeana 1914-18, after 7 years of successful and intensive crowdsourcing, content gathering, and community building throughout the continent, our thematic collection that you will see here, Europeana 1914-18, has built up a unique position in the World War I commemoration landscape. It's one of our most successful community-centric services of Europeana. It brings together over 400,000 objects from Europe's cultural heritage institutions, alongside thousands of personal stories, letters, diaries, and objects that really give us an insight into lived experiences across Europe during the war. So we designed a centenary tour, and this will build on this work. And it has been designed to encourage public participation through on and offline events. And we commenced the tour online with the launch of an exhibition called The Visions of War. And this exhibition draws on archive material from Europeana 1418 and artworks held in museums. So it examines how serving soldiers and official war artists depicted the conflict on the Western Front during the First World War in paintings, in drawings, watercolors, and sculptures. This is a unique combination of user-generated content and the material from the museums that brings the user a unique experience, and the user is actually telling us that they really like it because it's our best performing exhibition this year. And secondly, we're on a monthly basis highlighting different parts of the collections through blogs and galleries, often focused on a specific country. Offline, we're focusing on collection days and transcribathons in collaboration with our network of heritage institutions. Since 2011, when we first started inviting Europe citizens and cultural institutions to tell the story of World War I, nearly 15,000 citizens from 24 countries have digitized and shared around 200,000 objects to help tell their family stories, stories that shine a light on the shared human experience of the conflict. And as Europeana 1914-1918 has grown, so is the potential for how the collection can be shared and reused. One of those examples is Transcribathon. Europeana Transcribathon 1914-1918 builds on the crowdsourcing trend for volunteers to transcribe large numbers of historical documents with the help of a specially designed online tool. With this initiative, we aim to create a fully accessible record of the unique unpublished stories found in Europeana 1914-1918. To date, 8 Transcribeathon events and 7 online Transcribeathon runs have taken place across Europe, with more than 23,000 documents having been or currently being transcribed by over 1,700 volunteers. And as part of the European Year of Cultural Heritage, the Centenary Tour has brought events to Brussels, Warsaw, Athens, and Rome, and next week Nicosia. The Grand Centenary Tour Finale takes place on the 27th and 28th of November in Brussels to mark the ending of the World War I Centenary. And to showcase this, we've worked together with the House of European History and put a nice program together. So everybody's very welcome to attend should you be around in Brussels those days. Our contribution to the European Year is twofold. So this year we initiated, also empowered by this statement from Commissioner Thibault Navrasic, a campaign around the theme of migration. As many of us are not consciously aware that we are the product of many cultural influences. We designed the campaign so that it would both allow for room to engage with already digitized content, as well as allow for new contributions to be made and stories to be told. We started by building a thematic collection, identifying the material in our corpus of relevance to the theme of migration. And we were lucky that the European Year of Cultural Heritage coincided with the generic service project being awarded that responded to the same theme. Through our migration collection, we aim to show that the geographical moving of people makes culture richer. A key element of the campaign are also collection days, to collect stories and material relating to migration and family history. These days take place in partner museums and other cultural heritage institutions and are an opportunity for the public to share their own individual or family migration story. Here you see some pictures of how these days work, interview desks, digitization desks, people, young and old, a very lively and rewarding experience to be part of. And Europeana helps partners in setting up these days by offering expertise and knowledge of running collection days, including an online tool for capturing data with how-to tutorials. We provide press and marketing templates and give visibility for the organization hosting these events. Throughout 2018, we've been hosting collection days and events involving museums, libraries, archives across Europe that specialize in or are interested in the theme of migration. Here you see some of the partners who were involved and who without it would not have all been made possible. Alongside organizing physical events, we also invite the user of Europeana collections to share their stories online. Through this tool, as part of our migration collection, it's quite easy to share your story online. The story so far. Just a day before the European Year of Cultural Heritage was launched at the Culture Forum in Milan last year, December, the Europeana AGM took place. And this is when we first started to invite our network to participate in the campaign. The call to our network was taken up with lots of enthusiasm, and we have since held events in Brussels, Belgrade, Cardiff, Utrecht, Dublin, Pisa, Zagreb, Budapest, Luxembourg, and we'll be soon going to Riga, Athens, Limerick, and closing the year with an event in the National Library of the Netherlands, where Europeana has had its offices already for over 10 years. On the 18th of December, it's International Migrant Day, we will organize a collection day there with talks, music, discussion, interview tables to share stories and have your objects digitized. So the people are saying that it's been a rewarding experience for them to share their story, and it has been a rewarding ride for us as well. And when I heard Dr. Uwe Koch and Chiara Bellani speak about the legacy of the European Year of Cultural Heritage, I see this important work as one of the things we can and should continue and expand upon, and in partnership with our network of heritage institutions. Of course, a Europeana campaign is not complete with also engaging online audiences, so we've developed nice exhibitions, galleries, and blogs around the topic of migration, detailing how migration intertwines with art, science, and culture. So what's next? Next year we have another exciting participatory season in the pipeline, and we are looking forward to putting the spotlight on female innovators on Europeana to mark Women's History Month in March. Using rich cultural heritage from Europeana collections, this season will highlight the lives and achievements of remarkable women throughout history working in the arts and sciences. From composers to scientists, we'll share engaging stories in a series of editorial features on Europeana collections. And to complement the historical stories about female pioneers, we'll also run a parallel blog series on Europeana Pro, profiling leading women in the glam sector, highlighting their work and achievements. Lastly, I want to share with you our fantastic Give It Up competition. So through our participatory activities, we realize that it's essential to reach out and continue to connect people with our shared cultural heritage. And Give It Up is another cool example, and it's an annual gift-making competition for the most creative reuse of digitized cultural heritage material. This year, in its fifth edition, we're running this competition in collaboration with the Digital Public Library of America, Trove in Australia, and Digital NZ. And it's truly amazing to see how many people find their way to these gifts that have already received over 170 million views on the Giphy platform. If you feel inspired, you still have a few days to submit your own gift for this year's competition. And I think it's fair to say that your cultural heritage is alive and kicking, and we should all feel very motivated and inspired to build on the legacy of the European Year of Cultural Heritage and to continue to push each other forward, innovating with technology to make culture part of everyone's life. Thank you very much.